All right, guys and girls, this is Jerningham here, ladies and gentlemen. Apparently, this new virus hasn't reached the UK, which I find it hard to believe. I don't know if you guys and girls and ladies and gentlemen agree with me. Some of you may think it hasn't reached here by luck yet, but I think this disease has reached in the UK, and they're asking the people to actually come in and get tested. But saying that, if there's a lot of people on a plane with the disease and you don't know about it, all them passengers on the plane would have came off the plane from the UK, from Africa, with a load of other people and spread it anyway. So what it's supposed to one person, it's supposed to multiple people. So they said that with the Delta variant and the South African variant and the Kent variant. It's just the exact same thing. Let's see what they say about the virus.
Welcome to the programme. We start with growing concerns over the emergence of a new strain of COVID-19 in Southern Africa. The World Health Organization has been holding an urgent meeting in Geneva, and we're expecting a decision from them soon on whether to declare this a variant of concern. Let's look at what this new strain is doing to stock markets. They've been plummeting around the world, and you're looking at the Dow Jones Index in New York, coming back, obviously, the day after the Thanksgiving holiday. And you can see the drop
lens
there
as well,
coming up to 2.5-3%, obviously reacting to what's been happening in stock markets around the world. And nations around the world have, as we've been on air with Impact, also been imposing more travel bans within the past hour. The European Union has called for flights to the affected area to be suspended. And that's as Belgium detected the first case in Europe in an unvaccinated person returning from abroad. Let's listen to the announcement from the European Commission President, Ursula von der Leyen.
It is now important that all of us in Europe act very swiftly, decisively and united. The European Commission has today proposed to member states to activate the emergency brake on travel from countries in Southern Africa and other countries affected to limit the spread of the new variant. All air travel to these countries should be suspended. They should be suspended until we have a clear understanding about the danger posed by this new variant. And travelers returning from this region should respect strict quarantine rules.
Well, the new variant is thought to be much more infectious than the Delta version of COVID-19 that we've got used to. Multiple cases have been identified in South Africa, also Hong Kong, Botswana, one case in Israel as well. No cases have been confirmed in the UK, but Britain's Health Secretary, Sajid Javid, says the variant has a significant number of mutations, which means it could be more transmissible and current vaccines could be less effective. Our health correspondent, Catherine DaCosta, reports.
The emergence of a new highly complex variant in Southern Africa has sounded alarm bells around the world. So far, most cases have been identified in one province of South Africa, where it appears the variant may be driving a new wave of infection.
Early analysis show that this variant has a large number of mutations that require and will undergo further study. It will take a few weeks for us to understand what impact this variant has.
The new variant was only identified 4 days ago. Genetic analysis shows it has twice the mutations of Delta, the dominant variant worldwide, including 30 changes to the spike protein, which the virus uses to enter human cells.
We haven't got evidence that it's here yet. We haven't identified
it's
any...
It's bound to be in the UK.
And we're now sequencing and giving...
We're saying it's not in the UK. We're going to the UK, Northern Scotland, Ireland, Wales, America.
But there is travel from South Africa across the globe, and there are many rising cases in South Africa at the moment. So we'll need to be
people bring food imports in, it will come across anyway.
Current vaccines have been designed to target the spike protein from the original Wuhan strain. Some of the mutations in this new variant may mean the virus can spread more easily or make the vaccines less effective. But jabs still provide protection against other variants of concern and can be tweaked if needed.
It's highly unlikely that they won't have any effect. That really would be a catastrophe. But we may well see that the protection that we get is to some degree reduced, particularly because there are so many mutations in the part of the S protein that many of the antibodies bind to. So I don't think we're likely to see that vaccines don't work at all.
Flights to the UK have been suspended from 6 African countries till 4 a.m. on Sunday to allow time to set up quarantine hotels. The government hopes a new travel ban will delay the variant being brought into Britain.
We're working quickly, and we're working with a high degree of uncertainty. We are continuing to make assessments, including about those countries with strong travel links to South Africa. And we are working with our international partners, including South Africa and the European Union, to ensure an aligned response. But this variant is a reminder for all of us that this pandemic is far from over.
Labour welcomed the travel restrictions, but said better distribution of vaccines to poorer nations was essential. Vaccines and new antiviral drugs are still our best defence. We'll have to wait 2 to 3 weeks for scientists to understand the risk this new variant may pose. Catherine Da Costa, BBC News.
Well, there we are.
On Impact, we got a briefing from Martin Hiddle, who is Professor of Emerging Infectious Diseases at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine.
I think we should be cautious at this stage with the identification of this new variant. Clearly, it looks quite different from the other ones. It's based on a strain which has been observed for quite a while, but these new mutations make it look quite distinctive. And it's somewhat familiar story for the that we found for the Alpha variant, where it also acquired a lot of new mutations in one go. So yes, I don't see why we shouldn't put it on at the moment, even if it's precautionary.
In layman's terms, what aspect of the mutations are you most interested in?
So we don't know yet. It seems there's a lot of new mutations in this variant, and probably most of them are not very relevant. And I think that's why we have to do laboratory science to work it out. But the fact that it looks so different means that we should be concerned about this. We observed this in the Alpha variant, that a new strain came along that possibly through a long-term infection and derived some differences from the currently circulating strains. So yes, I think we should be worried, but it's not clear that what this new mutations will mean yet.
I suppose there are, in a way, two aspects. One is about the effectiveness of the virus in doing damage to its host. And the other is the transmissibility of this particular variant.
So in South Africa, there was also the Beta variant, and this one clearly had the ability to evade a lot of the immune response, but not all of the immune response. But that hasn't become the worldwide dominant strain, which is currently the Delta variant. And that's because it didn't transmit so well. So even if this variant does have resistance to previous immunity, it may not be transmissible enough to outcompete with the others. So it's a bit of a balance for us at the moment to work out,
controller.
How important this strain is going to become.
Would you compare where we are now to where we were when the Delta variant first emerged? Because it does seem that South African scientists have worked very fast to identify, to sequence this variant. I mean, is there any hope you draw from this?
Yes, so I mean, it's amazing that the worldwide effort has been monitoring strains from around the world, but South Africa has been doing a particularly good job at that. So yes, they've given us an early warning, and it's up to the rest of the world to take advantage of that early warning, and that's due to the competence and the ability of the South African researchers to give us that warning.
And in terms of response, should this become a variant of concern, should it, get out of the box, as it were, how effectively can vaccines be re-engineered? I mean, is this something that might be able to be a matter of months or even weeks?
So we were very surprised at how fast the vaccines were generated the first time. And I know that the companies have been preparing for a new variant which would be resistant to their vaccine. So I'm hopeful that we'll do it much faster than last time. And I hope to be surprised again. But it would take months.
Huh, there we go. We'll take months for this new one, apparently. Anyway, guys, girls, ladies, gentlemen, thank you for joining me. See you in the next one. Peace.
Our scientists are